Hello everybody, welcome back to the Real Advent Twitch channel. Today we'll be taking a look at the brand new and so far unreleased version of the Bullied Like Pacifics by Bossman Games. Before we get into any scenarios, I thought I'd just give a quick look around of what you get. Good evening Sugar Rush and Fox Red Buddy, hope you're both doing well. So the first variant is the modern look, so currently we have Four Valley, that's currently preserved at the Seven Valley Railway. See all the new number plates and name plates are all there. And they also are fitted with air brakes, and if you fit any tender, any clean tender to these modern, the tenders are also updated to have air brakes on as well. Good evening Joseph, hope you're doing well. Next up is the BR Green Weathered, which isn't fitted with air brakes like the modern one. Obviously it has that weathered and worked look. And also doesn't have the emblems like the clean version has. And last but not least, we have the BR Green Heritage look, which is very similar to the modern look, just doesn't have air brakes fitted. Also featuring in this pack is three different types of tenders. You have the 4,500 gallon tender, the 5,250 gallon tender, and the 5,500 gallon tender. Once again, all of these are featured in BR Green Modern, Heritage, and Weathered livery. And as you can see, if we head over to the different types, they are different gallon variants, more suited to long distance running. As well as Tor Valley in the modern era, you do get Braunton over here, based with locomotive services. And as you can see, the modern era variants do get headboards and a modern high lamp. There is 36 different headboards. I'll just run through a few of them for you. The Bossman Games Rail Tours headboard, it looks very similar to Sapphos Trains. But the Great Britain, the Scarborough Flyer, and then all of these. So there's just a few of the headboards, once again fitted with air brakes. If you do go to the tender here, because we have a modern engine, these have added the air brakes on the tender as well as the overhead live wires warning stickers. These electric lights also work when you turn on the generator. Yeah, there's plenty of choices, plenty of different customizations. So does anybody currently have any questions that would like answering before we jump into a scenario? And as well as headboards, you can stick as many lights on as you want. You just turn the modern lamp off. There you go, you can have as many different variations of lamp cords. You can also have a tail lamp, modern lamp, or a modern tail lamp as well. I think it might be easier if we just zoom out a little bit, and you can see the entire cab. So authentic cab by Bossman Games. You have all the injectors, firebox, glow, and obviously because we're on a modern variant, we have AWS and TPWS up there. For those just joining us, we're just having a quick look around the Light Pacific pack by Bossman Games that you will be able to buy shortly through Bossman Games. You get different... different whistle variations as well. Now this is an advanced loco, but if you do need some help, then you can turn on the auto fireman just there. No release date just yet from Bossman Games, but they have released their manual, so I'd assume very soon. You also have the firebox and multiple different cab views. Our favourite, sticking your head out just like that. So, we just had a quick look there at the pack and what you get. So, if you just give me 2 minutes, I will load up a scenario on the Riviera line with Braunton, so we can take it for a spin. So, for those that are thinking of purchasing it, for the scenarios you will need quite a few add-ons, including the AP coach pack. But we have got a scenario on the Riviera line that we've made ready for this stream. And of course you can build your own or free roam scenarios on your favourite line. Yes, a gala scenario on the North Yorkshire Moors route is a good idea. I'm guessing you're thinking of purchasing the pack when it's released then, Ben. Let's just restore that to default. Thank you very much for the subscription with Prime, Fox Red Buddy. You are our first ever subscriber, so thank you very much. So we're back in with Braunton. Once again, if you've got any questions or want to see anything about the pack, then fire away and I'll try and answer them. Let's get quickly set up. The castle there just making an absolute racket. So we'll put a headboard on this one. I think we'll go for the Devon Bell down that way. Passengers on. Wish us luck. We are ready to depart. Good evening, Callum. How are you doing this evening? Those just joining us, we're having a look at the upcoming release from Bossman Games, the Bullied Match Pacific. Currently heading towards Paignton with 3446 Braunton. We didn't have the Just Trains version, so first for us. Some water in while we stop. Whilst we're also stopped, we can take a look at the superb detail Bossman Games has gone into designing this loco. All the piston rods and coupling rods. And then you do have some animated features like the whistle. Looks like we're ready to depart. We might have a drive later of Tor Valley on the West Valley route, but we'll see how we get on with this one yet. for those just joining, we are looking at the upcoming release from Bossman Games, the Bullied Pacific, Light Pacific. Currently between Paignton and Torquay, with 34046. Just turn the HUD off for a minute, you can have a look at the linkage you're working away. Get the HUD back on so I can see how my water level's doing. Good evening, Jake. No need to be sorry, we've all got our own lines. We can, you've only missed us looking around the different styles of the tenders and looks you get, so I'm sure if we're back on the route, then we can have a look at the other variants as well. Yeah, fireworks on. Good hear either, so if you do hear a dog then you understand why. The injectors are on, Jake, but there's your water level for you. Thought we'd best put it on while we're going downhill. Yeah, this one's definitely not 158 where you just put the key in and drive away. Yeah, I've got the manual for this one printed out, so can quickly glance over it. This is Torquay. We made it this far, so that's a start. I run on a Ryzen 5 and a GTX 1650. Oh, inside I got popped so far, so. It depends on how I look, Jake, and how good train simulator is thinking of working. Anywhere between 30 and 65, depending on the route. Currently running at 30, so not too bad. I think we're running on about high or ultra, so. As long as it stays a constant 30, I'm not too bothered. Callum, it's in the top left corner for you. I don't know if that shows on your screen or not. Oh, that's good. I didn't know if you could see that. It's not really visible until you get to a dark background. We haven't managed to make it slip yet. I tried putting it full regulator, full reverse, and it didn't slip coming out of people, so. I'm built for a KWPR Gala, yes, tell them. Just tell me which stock you need and I'll get to it. Oh, it was only Sony, so yeah, that might have had an effect on it, mightn't it? The passengers on here. For anybody just joining us, we're having a look at the new pack from Bossman Games, the Bullied White Pacific. We're heading from heading from Goodrington up to Exeter, and then we'll be having a look on a different route, probably the Worth Valley, because it's got some steep hills, bit of a challenge. Wait for get some more water in. We can probably have a look at adding Sir Keith Park in, yes, Jake. I couldn't remember how to add Sir Keith Park in, but the manual's been released now, so it tells us how to do that. Right, let's get on his way. Yeah, that took a while to get out of Langothland, didn't it, Jake? And that's the cut-down version, I think, so... I think it took about 20-25 minutes to get out of Langothland. Joseph, it comes with early and late crest on the tenders, so, and both of them come in either weathered or clean variants, so completely down to you which sort of look you want to go for. Yeah, we did receive a comment from Tom. Of a climb out of the station here. Now, Jake, I do remember you asking what it did it look like in the cab. So while you're here, there you go. Quickly reset that to default so it doesn't look too fish-eyed. If you do manage, you have to come back and let us know if you manage to get it to slip. Yes, I was watching your stream earlier. I did notice you managed to get out of the key without slipping. Yeah, no worries, Fox Red Buddy. See you soon. Yeah, it takes a lot of fitness, doesn't it, to drive and fire a steam locomotive. Oh, your local station is Newton Abbot, is it, Joseph? I believe Brompton's been there through there recently. I don't think I've ever encountered Braunton yet, Jake. I've obviously encountered Sir Keith Park. It looked a very busy event, Callum. Did all change? I can't remember, was it a 1 day event or a 2 day event? Yeah, still going, we haven't run out of water yet, so that's good. The only thing about North Wales Coast, the route, the only thing I regret about it is not getting the Holyhead extension, really. I'm hoping they do this, a similar thing with the Welsh Motors, where they take all the branding off. I'm hoping that happens. Have you put it on your wall yet, Callum? Your nameplate. Oh, it weighs quite a bit, does it? I'd imagine so. It looks quite big. Passengers on here. Is there anything anybody wants to look around at the locomotive while we stop? Some more water in while we're stopped as well. Yeah, that's another pack I'm hoping they re-release, but unbranded, is the 390 pack, but I guess we've got the Avant US Coast variant now, so get the water up to 70% and then we'll go. So for anyone just joining us, we're just departing Newton Abbot. We are heading towards Exeter with 34046 Brompton, which is part of the new Light Pacific pack from Bossman Games, who have very kindly sent us over a copy to have a look before it's released. Any time in the next couple of days, Callum, I'm free towards the evening. I'll let you know if I've got any plans to kind of stream any extra content, because people seem to be enjoying the streams at the minute. But to get her up to speed. What is Braunton's max speed? We listed up here. Anybody know Matt Braunton's max speed on here? I'm guessing 60 or 75. Alright, we can get up to max speed then. Yeah, West Somerset's quite a long line, isn't it, Callum? Whereas Keithley West Valley's quite a short one. Stop is Teignmouth. That's slowing down for the stop. I've never been Josie, so thank you for that pronunciation. Yeah, we're waiting to get the AP Mark 1s. I'm hoping there might be a sale at some point in the next month to get those. I've noticed quite a few quite a few scenarios and I'll need them, so. Let passengers on. Doing alright so far. Now we have parked underneath a bridge, so I don't think I can show you this simulation. So I'll show you this at the next stop, but these brake blocks do release. Do have that simulation on. They do look very nice, Jake. As I say, just waiting for a sail really now. And we are ready. I believe so, Jake. Cheed1989, thank you very much for that follow, very much appreciated. Would help if I took the brake off before taking the hood off, wouldn't it? You see, every time I seem to go out for a real tour, they've always got the cylinder valves open. And away she goes. I either got lucky or I'm actually learning this low floor shit. Let's put the hood back on. Oh, does it actually provide power then, Jake, now? For those just joining us, we're just about to arrive in Dawlish with a 3404 Warnton. This comes from the upcoming captain from Bottom Games, the Bully Black Pacific. If you do have any questions, then ask away. Well, which diesel do you use, Jake? We do have some light here as well, so we can show you the brakes releasing. Turn the injectors off. And there you go, they've just released for us. Try and get a better shot of them next time. Yes, we are running in summertime, yeah. The sun shows off the green paint just nicely. Yeah, no leaves on the line, you see. Grow on the trees. Nice sunny day. We are heading to Exeter on this run. When we stop, I'll bring you up where we've got left to call. then we might have a quick go on what Father wants to finish this one. Let's see if we can have another go at seeing these brake blocks release. There we go, we saw it this time. Yeah, that was quite a big firework, was that one. He's been asleep for the other time, so... He's doing all right so far. Yeah, some of them can be quite loud, can't they? And of course, thanks to everybody, when we stop, we will definitely look at the remaining stops. Completely forgot trying to look at some brake blocks releasing. Thank you. Well, Jake, it's not gone wrong so far. Right, so we have Exminster Exeter St. Thomas, and get a better writing somewhere. We have Exminster Exeter St. Thomas and Exeter left to go, and we have come from Goodrington. Had quite a few stops on his way. You might notice your local station somewhere. I'm guessing once you learn steam and injectors in train sim, everything else is fairly similar really. We'll just wait for this train to come in and then we will depart. Our next stop is City of St David's, which is our penultimate stop on this scenario. For those that are just joining us, we're taking a look at the upcoming Bullied White Pacific from Boston Games. They've kindly sent me a copy to have a look at and show off early. If you have any questions about the pack, then ask away in the chat and I'll do my best to answer them. If you're interested in knowing what we're doing next, we're going to be taking these on the Wolf Valley. I'll obviously be doing a full review on the Real Advent website in the coming days, but my first impressions are this is a very good pack from perhaps over at Bossman Games. Definitely one to add to your collection if you we do have the modern Riviera Line Callum, but we'd go on the older version to bring in some more steam. But if you'd like to see the modern Riviera Line, then maybe we can slot that into a future stream. Is that all you need to run the Seven Valley, is it, Callum? I thought it needed more, actually. I have it downloaded, I just need to install it, so... I'll quickly go and check the specs when we finish this scenario, see which ones we need or have already got. Unless one of you two can bring up the specs. We don't have the Isle of Wight and TS, we've only got that in Train Sim World 2. Crikey, that's cheap for a route, is that $3.99? That was a quick stop. Exeter is our next stop. And the final one on this scenario. Thank you for that link, Callum. I'll take a look soon. And there we go, that is Exeter. Successful run from Goodrington Sands to Exeter.